प्रोफेसर एसी जाधव, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नासिक. अंडर द कोर्स ऑफ हॉट 354 वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द पैकेज ऑफ प्रैक्टिसेस फॉर ग्रोइंग ट्यूबरोज. गाइस, दिस वीडियो इज ओनली फॉर द एजुकेशनल पर्पस एंड नॉट फॉर एनी ऑफ द कमर्शियल यूज. ट्यूबरोज, इट ऑक्युपाइज अ वेरी सिलेक्टिव and the special position among the ornamental bulbous plant for its beauty, elegance and the sweet pleasant fragrance. It has a great potential for cut flower trade and essential oil industry. Due to their great demand, it is currently cultivated in most of tropical and subtropical countries of the world, and that's why it is considered one of the important type of the floricultural crop as a cut and the loose flower. Tuberose, which is commonly called as a Rajnigandha, Nishigandha also. Tuberose has a long, narrow, light green color leaves. Plants grow about 25 to 30 centimeter tall. Flowering stalk is 75 to 100 centimeter long, having 25 to 50 florid spike as per the different variety. It produces waxy, white, highly fragrant, single semi, double or double flower on a long spike which open from the base to the top. Single variety has been named after the place of growing as a Mexican single, Calcutta single, Hyderabad single, Coimbatore single, etc. Tuberose bloom during the summer, rainy season and autumn season, and thus it become a very important cut flower of the summer and also the rainy season of India. Tuberose, which is identified with the botanical name, that is Polyanthus tuberosa, and comes under the family, that is Amaryllidaceae. Origin, or it is the native of Mexico, from where it is reached to the different part of the world. Tuberose, regarding its importance and uses. It is one of the important cut flower used for a vase decoration and bouquet preparation. Means, though the color of the spike is white, but due to their attractive appearance and the fragrance, this is the one of the peculiar flower or the popular flower. The floral stalk is 75 to 100 centimeter, which indicated the long vase life, and it bear the white and different colored flower spike or the floret. Spike or the tuberose are used as a cut flower due to its delightful appearance, sweet fragrance, good keeping quality, and due to the highly fragrant used to extract its valuable essential oil. Then varieties. When we are concerned with the variety, there are the four types of the variety found in tuberose on the basis of number of rows of petals in which there is a single, semi-double, double and the variegated. Single flower variety. Single flower variety or the cultivar have a single row of the petals. Floral buds are greenish white, whereas the flower are waxy white. Loose flower are used for the decoration and the floral arrangement. Flowers are highly fragrant and hence are used for the extraction of essential oil, which percent at about 0.08 to 0.11%. Seed setting is observed in a single flowered varieties. The well-known cultivator under these varieties are like a Calcutta single, Phule Rajni, Mangalore single, Coimbatore single, etc. Then next important variety, it is the semi-double. Semi-double flower tuberose means in this type flower, the petals are in two or the three rows and mostly the flowers are white. Then double flower tube rose. As the name indicate, the flower have more than 3 rows of the petals on a long and sturdy spike. Flower opens slowly and therefore it is highly suitable as a cut flower. It has a pinkish tinge at the top of the flower buds, flower color in a white. The pearl is a variety which is again considered under the double flower tuberose category. And third one is a variegated type of the tuberose. So variegated type of the tuberose means which has a leaf margin with a tinge of white or the golden color, and mostly they are suitable for the landscaping planning or landscaping planting due to their attractive appearance of the foliage. So they are again comes under the two types, that is the variegated single and the variegated double. Variegated single, it's an example like a rajat rekha which has a white margin on the leaves, and the variegated doubles which has a golden margin. Examples are dhaval, swarnarekha, etc. Other well-known cultivars of tuberose are, that is a Srinagar, Prajwal, Suhasini, Vaibhav, etc. Then regarding the climatic and the soil requirement of this crop. So first of all, we will discuss the soil requirement. Tuberose, which is considered as a bulbous type of the plant, and hence we have a need of the good type sandy loam or loamy type of the soil with a good drainage for the production of the good flower and the bulb. The soil should have good pH range, or the neutral type of the pH range, that is 6.5 to 7.5 with a good aeration and definitely the good drainage. It is observed that it can be tolerate the higher degree of the pH up to the 8.2 and 8.3, but we have a need of the some type of the reclamation in this case also. The soil should be a rich in organic matter and also has a good water holding capacity for the proper growth of tuberose. So this is about the soil required for the cultivation of tuberose. Then regarding the climatic parameters or the requirement. So tuberose is a half hardy bulbous crop and happily grow in a milder type of the climatic condition. It can be tolerate the wide range of the climatic condition and the areas having the ranges of 20 to 35 degrees Celsius temperature, and consider good for its successful growth also. So for its luxuriant growth, high and the high productivity, the mild temperature of about 30 degrees Celsius with a high humidity is considered to be the most suitable type of the climatic condition. Then the temperature above 40 degrees Celsius definitely reduces the productivity and the quality of the spike. And in contrast cases, like a much lower temperature having 1 to 2 degrees Celsius with a ground frost, kill the vegetative parts of the crop completely. So however, sprouting and the flowering is normal in the routine crops with the onset of the spring. So this is about the climatic requirement of tuberose crop. Then we will go for the discussion regarding the propagation. So this is the bulbous crop and propagated by means of the bulb. But in case of the bulb, selection of the bulb is very important one. The size, then size of the bulb, its diameter, then the weight reflect the storage of food material which will be utilized for the growth, flower production and subsequent production of the new bulbs. In tuberose, production of the daughter bulbs and flower production go simultaneously, and hence sufficiently good size bulb should be used for the planting. So this size, or under this size, the dimension of 1.5 to 2 centimeter and with the weight of 30 to 40 grams of the bulb is considered to be the ideal for the plantation. And definitely the bulb should be healthy one. It should be free from any type of the pest and the disease, infection and the infestation. And as a precautionary measure, we should properly treat the bulb by using any type of the fungicides for certain period of the time and then after use for the plantation. So this is the propagation which we can follow in a tuberose crop. Then regarding the planting, so before the planting, we have a need of properly following the different tillage practices, because we have a need of the good tilth, and for these two or the three types of the plowing we can follow before the plantation. And then on a ridges and furrow type of the layout, the planting should be followed with the best period of time, that is April to May, with facility of the irrigation. The spacing which we can adopt in tuberose, it is 30 by 30 centimeter or 30 by 20 centimeter. So in this way, at the time of the planting, by adopting such type of the spacing, we have a need of the seed rate, that is 5000 to 6000 kg of the bulb for 1 hectare area. And when we are count the bulb in the numbers, we can say it should be near about 1.6 lakh to 2.5 lakh bulbs per hectare. Then regarding the nutrition and irrigation requirement of this crop. So this is the bulbous crop, and that's why need of the good type of the nutrient application, because consider as a heavy feeder and a very exhaustive type of the crop, and thus respond well to the applied organic and inorganic nutrients too. So at the time of the plantation or the land preparation, we should incorporate near about 20 tons of the well-rotated FYM per hectare. And in addition to this one, we have a need of 200 kg of nitrogen, phosphorus and potash per hectare. This is the recommended dose, and in which the nitrogen we will split into the two doses, which should be at 45 days after planting and 90 days after planting. Then regarding the irrigation, it required the sufficient moisture for its growth and the quality flower production. So it is advisable that the light type of the irrigation should be given before the planting, and which help in early sprouting and the growth of the plant. Many times the too much moisture at the time of the sprouting of the bulb result into rotting of the bulb. And similar condition during the flowering affect the quality of the spike adversely. So the frequency of the irrigation depend upon the soil type, weather condition and the stage of the growth. In general, weekly irrigation is required during April-June. Irrigation interval during the July-September depend upon the rains and their intensities, whereas during the October to the March, irrigation at the interval of the 10 days keeping the rains in view is deficient to meet its requirement. So such type of the practice is considered to be advisable during the management practices of irrigation in tuberose. Then harvesting and yield of the tuberose. So the crop is ready for the harvest 3 to 4 months after the plantation. For the cut flower, the spike are to be cut when the lowermost of 1 to 2 foraids have opened, because the flower has a long spike with a 15 to 17 number of the floret per spike. And out of this, we have a need of lowermost 1 or 2 floret is to be open in a cut category. After cutting the base of the spike, immediately we should place it in a water or a bucket containing the water. Then after the harvesting of the flower, then flowers are definitely placed in a shady area in a wet cotton cloth. Or in a gunny bag which retain the turgidity and the moisture and avoid the shrinkage from the shriveling or the shrinkage or the transpiration rate from the petal area. Then yield, The bulb once planted gives the commercial yield up to the 3 year. So, as a cut flower, from the 1 hectare area, we can obtain 7 to 8 lakh flower spike. While as a loose flower, from the 1 hectare area, we obtain 7 to 7.5 tons of the loose flower per hectare. So this is the yield in case of the tuberose. Then regarding the plant protections measure, the insect which are common or observed in this category are the aphid, thrips, red spider mite, and also many cases as per the soil conditions, root rot, nematodes, then grasshoppers and weevils also. Aphids, thrips, they are the sucking pest. Aphid, these are the very small size insect feed on the flower buds and on growing tips. This can be controlled by spraying imidacloprid 200 SL 0.4 at the rate 0.4 ml per liter of the water. Then regarding the thrips, they feed on the leaves, then flower stalk and flowers, and suck the sap, and ultimately they damage the crop. And it can be controlled by spraying ethionol 50 EC at the rate of 2 ml per liter of the water. Then red spider mite, yellow strips and streaks appear on the foliage due to the attack of this mite. We can control this mite by spraying ethionol 50 EC at the rate 2 ml per liter of the water. Then regarding the diseases, majorly in this crop, leaf blight, which is again known as a botrytis spot, then alternaria leaf spot, and stem rot, that is sclerotial wilt, it is the common type of the diseases. Leaf blight, this disease is caused by the botrytis elliptica and causes the serious damage to the leaves. It can be controlled by spraying chlorothalonil 75 WP at the rate 2.5 ml per liter of the water. Then alternaria leaf spot, it is again one of the severe or the danger disease in a tuberose, and it is caused by alternaria species, and faint concentric rings appear on the midrib of the leaves, but rarely near the margin of the leaves. Many times we observe, then the leaves become necrotic, then dry up with the infection, and such type of the problem we can control by spraying the different types of the systemic insecticide, fungicide, like diethan M45 at the rate of or 2%, then stem rot. The main symptoms are appears on the spot of the green and the brown round spot on the leaves, and the leaves become yellow and ultimately dry up also. The fungus ultimately attack the root, and the infection gradually spread to the bulb and collar portion of the stem, which causes the rotting. So drenching the soil with a barley steam at the 0.5 or up to the 1% is effective in controlling this disease, and if necessary we can repeat the same type of the practice at the 20 days interval to control such type of the stem rot. So this is about the plant protection measures against the disease and the pest in a tuberose. So this is about the whole detailed cultivation practice in a tuberose. Thank you very much.